Break on and break. Break on. Hey guys, John Rocket, Davey One here, showing you my beauty little cen-tech hockey free battery charger. And I guess the reason I'm showing you this is because for the money, this thing has really, it is still winter here in southern New Hampshire. And for the most part, my tractors live outside. And that, you know, that, if, you know, some of the tractors, it's even your car or your truck or whatever, if they live outside and they, you know, the temperature goes below freezing, or like it does up here in New Hampshire, it definitely gets down to zero. I don't know about all that global warming, whatever, but yeah. And if the wind is blowing, then you get that wind chill. So if your truck or your tractor or your or whatever lives outside, your snow removal equipment like mine does, lives outside, having a hot battery in the house that you can jump start or anything else, you know, jump with the battery. And I guess this is what I'm here to talk about. It's this charger, and this is what it is. It's a battery charger. It is better than a battery maintainer in that it actually does put out some amperages. And you can read the instruction manual on the exact numbers, because I'm not really going to talk about that there. I don't even remember the damn pot number. I'm not taking it out of the box. I've had this for a couple of months now. It is a 12-volt battery charger, and they have 2-amp, 10-amp, and 50-amp on there. And I watched a couple of guys on YouTube with this before I got this thing. I think I want to say it was like on sale for $29 and change, maybe even a little less. And you throw that 20% coupon at it, and you run away with this thing for like $20-something. Cheap, cheap. However, I was using one of those little black boxes, and they just don't last. And when they go bad, and it's all over. So one of the gigs is, I'm going to show you here, is that this does have different things, you know, different amps on there. And they say, oh, 50 amps stop. Well, yeah, let's talk about that. Unplug the unit, right? Okay. Now, 50 amps is quite a bit of juice. You know, you could definitely draw an arc with 50 amps for certain. All you got to really do is look at some of the smaller welders. And, you know, that's in the neighborhood of cooking sheet metal. Easy peasy. But if you look at the cables here on this, I can't tell you exactly what gauge wire that is, but I'm going to just say that it's barely 10 gauge if it is 10 wire. And 10 wire, if it is 10 wire, is only good for 30 amps. So that being said, there was a guy on YouTube trying to start a completely dead battery that we have no idea. Now, a battery charger, no battery charger, is going to help a completely dead junk battery. It's just not going to work. The battery's sulfating inside. There's a short inside. It's low on juice, on water, or battery acid, or whatever goes in there. And you're just not going to bring it back. And this brings me to why, if you had ever been at a garage that actually had a charger, the thing had wheels and it weighed like 100 pounds. And that is because it's got a giant transformer in there and cables on there that are probably 0 or 2 gauge. Because the starter, at least on your, you know, your old Chevy pickup truck, that might draw 150 amps. And there's no way you can get 150 amps through these cables. No way. You can't get 50 amps through these cables without them melting up and if it was touching something, starting a fire. And it will help. So that being said, the 50 amp spot your car thing is probably right next to out of it. However, it may, this is, you know, like computer chip controlled. And it may, which is why they make noise when you put that on 50 amp, it's probably pulsing. And so, at some way, it may be throwing, you know, split seconds worth of 50 amps, which just isn't no good. It's not going to start the car that way one way or another. However, if you have a battery that lives outside and it goes, a 12-volt battery like this one, which is a gel battery, and this does have the AGM switch on it, or regular lead-acid batteries, the battery, any 12-volt battery, is going to be somewhere between 12.3 and 12.8. And that will show you how good it is. If it goes down below 11 or 10 volts when you go to put it on load, there's something wrong with the battery. However, if the battery is being charged by your vehicle, it will be something at around 13.8, which is that the battery is getting a little bit of charge and your accessories are also being run. Excuse me. If you got an old vehicle and your headlights are going up and down, well, that will show you that your battery is definitely taking a load and your alternator is not doing it good enough. So here's a little Sperry meter that I've had for 100 years, and I got it on 20 volts, and hopefully you're going to be able to see that when I hook these cables up. Yeah, maybe I could do it one-handed or something. And we'll put this on here, and let me see. Where's my battery here? Where am I at? Okay, this battery is actually good because it's been on here, and I got 12.8. Hopefully you guys are seeing that in the photo there. 12.8. I'm on my 20-volt scale, DC, and 12.8. So that battery is good just sitting there. And it's not a new battery for certain. However, having one of these chargers to be able to let that trickle charge, it will do with 2 amp, which next to one of those little black box battery maintainers that only does fractional amperage, like dot two, or you know, a quarter of an amp, something you plug your motorcycle into in the wintertime, and in the spring you still got a decent battery. That's different. That's a trickle charger. This is actually a battery charger. A trickle charger is sort of a maintainer. This, because it is computer controlled, you know, it's got a CPU chip in there. It is. It does have a transformer in it, which is why it weighs something. Which for the money, you know, you really can't beat it. So as long as you come home with one that works, and you're not trying to start a vehicle that's been outside in the snowbank all year, and it's got a dead battery in it from 1942, you're probably going to work out pretty good. So this for the money is actually a pretty decent gig. If I plug this in. Pardon my arm, pardon my elbow, plug it in. It comes up, you'll see it says it's taking a charge, and this battery is good. So as soon as the little CPU chip in there senses the voltage, it's going to go ahead and the light will go green. I have put batteries that were marginally good, and I have had, you know, in a pinch, tried to charge stuff that was no good, put regular water in them, whatever I had, anything to keep the thing wet, the cells wet. And then, you know, eventually get the tractor started with a jump from another battery. But connect, there you go, now it's off. And that's what this thing does. It will turn it off, and it will stop down at, here, let me see if I can get this back in the photo for you, while it's on the charger. I believe it, there I go. I'm at, right at about 13. Hope you guys are seeing that there. And that's perfect. Any more than that, you'd be cooking the battery off if you're not using it. And it probably will take up to 14 volts. But where this one is sealed and it's not open, a vented lead acid battery, anything more than 14 volts with no load on it, and you'll be cooking the battery acid out of it. So that's no good. And then eventually the battery will be no good. So thanks for watching, you guys.